Discovery-based learning basically means having an experience that the students are engaged in, actively engaged in, and for us in this classroom, in this laboratory, we don't know the answers either. So pretty much we're in it with the students, and we're just kind of guiding them and working closely with them so that we all discover together. And I think that really nicely models for them the real life experience.
Yeah, there's not necessarily a guarantee of success or failure on any given experiment, because in a lot of ways they're doing something that maybe in the classroom we haven't done before, and we've investigated how to do it with them, but they may be trying it out for the first time, so it's about their experience of discovery as much as it is about ours.
Unlike other laboratory classes, we teach you the tools that you need, and you may fail at that tool. And so discovery-based courses utilize that as the kind of underlying pedagogical technique, trying to have the students be comfortable with this approach, walking in to an unknown and saying, hey, look, guys, it's okay. We're all in this together.
It's more about learning how to do the science correctly, how to plan the experiments, how to analyze the data, how to troubleshoot when things go wrong, how to sum up and accurately present the data.
In here, we really encourage students to figure out what they're going to do. Not only do they learn how to approach a problem, they improve in their ability to deal with frustration and tolerate failure, which happens a lot in a research laboratory.
It was really amazing how the students took the skills, the technical skills that they did in the fall quarter, and then combine them with kind of the scientific process they had been learning through the year to apply them to their independent projects. They came up with the research idea, they came up with the hypothesis and the question and how to go about testing it. It was just really awesome to see them kind of put that all together and run these independent projects.
They become more comfortable with criticism, with being able to stand up and present the data to the rest of a group, and having a group raise a point and then being okay taking that point, becoming more objective in distancing themselves from the data that they have.
I think for the students, they like it because they really feel that we're in it with them. We're not the pedantic, knowing all professors, teachers, whatever, but we actually are at their level. It's helpful to them to say, oh, professors don't know everything, they're in it with us.
A lot of what we notice is an increase in confidence in their own ability and their own knowledge set, really getting into the science and learning and growing and proposing a lot and going on to do great things outside of here.
If they do something wrong in the experiment and we see it, we may not correct them just so that they can learn from that experience. We try to be as supportive as possible, and we get them to think through what went wrong, and we'll sit with them and discuss if they're having to repeat something, why they might be having to do that.
When should we step back and say that they've been given enough information to then go solve that problem, figure out that puzzle on their own without us spoon feeding it to them?
The key thing with any population, the more you force a student, encourage a student, demand from the student that they explain it, use it, apply it, they're going to grow.
I think the same sense of unknown that the students have when they're in here, they don't know what's going to happen next. It's not necessarily prescribed what they're going to do. That same sense of sort of adventure and unknown is also present for us, because while we may set a course and a direction at the beginning, based on the outcome of the experiments as they happen, that may change what direction we need to go, how we need to troubleshoot something. So there's sort of a sense of adventure and exciting fun that we're along on the trip with the students as they take it.
Seeing a lot of the aha moments. It's like, I wasn't really sure and I was a bit confused, but now I totally get it. And so that's really fun, and they're excited to come to lab. You know, a lot of students want to come in on a Friday to check their results that they incubated the day before, even though we don't have lab, but they don't want to wait the weekend. They want to see what the results are. So it's really cool to see the students so excited.
Watching them have that moment,
yeah,
where they get excited and have that, oh, I think this was it. Maybe this is how we can overcome it. And watch them get revved up and excited about the topic is very fulfilling.
I think in general, they have to be patient, be flexible, and adapt to the situation going on in their classroom, and learn to ask questions and guide and not be pedantic and teach, not give them information.
Flexible is key. Having a plan, but being flexible to change that plan at any given time, and being okay with slowing down and really experiencing the journey with the students and not trying to rush to an end point. Just to get to the end point.
Right. It's about the process. It's not about the result.
Be okay with failure. Be generous with your time and be patient. Give it a try. It's worth the time.